I made the reservations for 8:15. We're gonna be late.
Dr. Mandrakis?
Mandrakis. It's okay. Everyone gets it wrong the first time. You're Jill. Come on in.
Hi, Jill. I'm Mrs. Mandrakis. Honey, could you get this for me, please? Thank you. Oh, I wrote the number of the restaurant on the notepad by the phone. Now, if we're not home in 2 hours, that means we've decided to go on to a movie and won't be back till after midnight. Is that okay?
Sure.
I've told my service to pick up any calls coming in on my office phone, so...
Oh, the children are asleep upstairs. First door on your left at the top of the landing. Now, they're both just getting over really bad colds, and I had a terrible time getting them to sleep. So, please, try not to wake them.
Okay.
Do you have any questions?
No.
Okay, great. We're late. Let's go ahead.
Make yourself at home. The refrigerator's
low. Okay. Bye.
Oh, we even have some low-fat yogurt in there.
Honey, come on, will you?
Yeah, I've been here for about an hour already.
Isn't it a neat house?
I guess I haven't looked around much.
Did you see his kids?
They were asleep when I got here.
They're really cute. So, what's going on?
You think you're going to be talking to him sometime tonight?
Who?
Bobby.
Probably. You know, Bobby asked me to go out with him this weekend, and I was really, really tempted. Because I like Bobby a lot, as much as you do. But I told him I couldn't, because I didn't think it was right, because you were my friend.
You are my friend.
Yeah, I guess so.
Listen, do me a favor. Just give Bobby the number here, okay? Don't tell him I told you to.
Okay. I gotta go now.
Okay. Bye, Nance. Thank you.
Yeah, bye.
Bye. Hello? Bobby?
Have you checked the children?
What? Dr. Mandrakis? Oh, yeah, sure. Dr. Mandrakis.
Thank you.
check the children?
Robert, I don't think this is very funny. Bobby. Who is this? Dr. Mandrakis there. This is his babysitter.
Hold on a minute. Hello?
Hello, yes.
Dr. Mandrakis left the restaurant about 40 minutes ago.
40 minutes ago?
That's right.
Okay. Getting phone calls about every 15 minutes. It's a man. I think he's trying to scare me.
An anonymous caller, ma'am?
That's right.
Has he threatened you?
No.
Has he been using obscene language?
No. Sometimes he doesn't say anything. He just keeps calling.
Well, there's really nothing we can do about it down here. Is the phone listed in your name?
No, I'm just a babysitter.
It's probably just some weirdo. The city's full of them. Believe it or not, we get reports like this every night. It's nothing to worry about.
Oh.
Have you tried whistling?
What?
Well, if you can find a good loud whistle somewhere in the house, blow it into the phone hard next time he calls. Probably break his eardrum. He won't bother you after that.
No, you're probably right. It's nothing to worry about. Hello?
Why haven't you checked the children?
Thank you.
Seventh Precinct, Sergeant Sagger.
I called you before about the man who keeps calling me.
Oh, yeah.
He called me again.
Did you try whistling?
No, he's out there.
Out where?
In the neighborhood. He's watching me through the windows.
Did you see him?
No, but I know he's there.
Is the house locked up?
Yes.
Well, then you're safe. If he wanted to break in, he wouldn't be calling you.
Please, can't you help me? I'm all alone here.
Okay, now take it easy. I'll tell you what. If this guy calls you again...
He will call again. I know he will.
All right, now calm down. Look, I can alert the phone company so that if he calls again, we can try to trace a call. What's your number there?
555-2368.
And the address?
Uh, 3370 Bridge.
Oh, yeah, I know where that is. Okay, now, if the guy calls again, you try to keep him on the line for at least a minute so we can trace a call.
I can't do that. He doesn't stay on for more than a couple seconds.
Well, that's the only way we can help you. By the way, what's your name?
Jill Johnson.
Jill, the important thing is for you to relax. Now, you're safe where you are. We've got patrolmen cruising that area all night long. Just stay calm. Would you do that for me?
Yes.
Okay, in the meantime, we'll be watching your line. All right, Jill?
Yes.
You call again if there's any problem.
Okay.
Good night.
I know. Who are you? I'm not going to be here much longer. Dr. Mandrakis and his wife are coming home.
I know.
Can you see me?
Yes.
Sorry, I turned the lights down. Turn them back up if you like.
Don't.
Don't. You really scared me. If that's what you wanted. Is that what you wanted?
No.
What do you want?
Your blood all over me.
You don't know who I am or where I live. And Dr. Mandrakis will take me home. Or maybe even the police.
Call the police.
I want to talk to you.
Coming from inside the house. Our squad car's on the way over there right now. Just get out of that house.
Here yet?
Yeah, they arrived about 10 minutes ago.
Christ. What a homecoming.
What happened, Charlie?
We were less than a block away when the call came through. When we got here, the guy was still upstairs in the kid's bedroom. He was covered with blood.
Blood?
Not his own. The children had been dead for several hours.
Jesus.
Been using some old phone the parents never had disconnected.
Who is he?
Well, we found this merchant Siemens card on him. He's English, been in this country less than a week ago.
How about the babysitter?
She'll be all right.
Dr. and Mrs. Mandrakis, I'm Lieutenant Clifford. I'm very sorry about this. I'll try to be as brief as possible.
Sit down.
Thank you.
So, you're in business for yourself now?
Yes, sir.
For the past 3.5 years.
That's good. And you'd heard about Kurt Duncan's escape?
Oh, yes.
Do you think the police will find him?
Well, I know they haven't assigned anyone to it specifically. It's an old case.
An old case.
Can you find him?
Yes. Maybe not tomorrow, maybe not this week. But I'll find him.
He could be anywhere by now.
I don't think so. Because he's a foreigner, he'll come back to the city. After 6 years in confinement, that's the only place that's familiar to him. That's important.
Man murders two children in cold blood. The jury declares him insane. How could such a person not be? He's sent to a state mental institution where the security is less than perfect. And he escapes. It isn't fair. A thing like that should never be allowed to happen again.
I couldn't agree with you more.
Go ahead, then. My accountant will contact you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Stay hot, little.
Kirk Duncan isn't going to run right out and kill more children. I'm not worried about that. We had him in here for 6 years under continuous therapy, some of it rather forceful. And drugs, tranquilizers, depressants, lithium. Eventually anyone will respond to the treatment here.
You gave him an electric shock?
Yes, some.
It says here 38. 38 times?
It's a fairly standard procedure.
Well, what will happen to him now without the drugs he was on?
Well, there'll be some deterioration. That's inevitable. You can't say how much.
And during the time that you had him here, did you discover any particular habits of his, peculiarities, quirks? Anything that might help me find him?
Well, yes, of course. It's all in the folder, Mr. Clifford.
Any mail from people back in England? Family?
That, too, is in the folder.
Let's get something straight here, Doctor. I've been 33 years in the business of tracking people down and putting them away. I spent almost a year on Kurt Duncan alone with the trial and the testimonies and the background investigations. Now, I didn't come here today to look in your goddamn folders. In fact, I wouldn't be here at all if you'd done your job right.
This is a hospital, Mr. Clifford, not a penitentiary. Everything appertaining to one of our patients is meticulously recorded in that patient's folder, whether you can make sense of it or not. Do you want to know how much we really understand of the human mind? Listen, this is Kurt Duncan, shortly after he was admitted here 6 years ago.
It's to give you medication that will calm you down. We're not putting anything in your food either.
No, I don't eat the food. It doesn't taste right.
That's Duncan.
Kurt, why are you fidgeting? Can't you get comfortable?
No! I'm not comfortable!
Don't you look at me. Don't you talk to me. Don't you touch me. Stay away. Stay away.
Kurt, I'm only trying to help
stay.
You.
Whoa!
Hello. What you been up to?
My own business. Look. Thanks for the light. Okay.
Next round's on me.
Look, I've got my own money, so if you don't mind.
After what I've been through, I don't mind anything. See, that's the whole point. My mind. Your mind. Where do they fit in? Do you see what I mean?
Okay, pal.
Do you live around here?
Get off of me!
Oh, listen, I didn't mean anything. And I, you see, I don't live around.
Hey!
I think the lady wants to be left alone. I think an apology is in order. Is that the best you can do? I think you better move along, pal.
No, it's okay, really.
No, I want him out of here, man. Hey, are you deaf? Go on, beat it! Hey, I'm not gonna say it again, mister.
I don't know why I keep coming back to this dump.
Thank you.
Hey, Cliff. Hey, come on, let me fix your drink,
man. Let me talk to you.
Later. No, thanks. What's going on?
I'm talking to you.
Sorry. Yeah, you know people here.
Yes, I do.
What's going on?
I want to talk to you privately. Huh?
Oh, hey, come on, Cliff. I can't take any more surprises tonight, huh? You did this, you dirty dog. You come on.
Yeah, you did. Let's upstairs for a minute.
All right.
Now, what's going on? Come, tell Papa. Hey, you getting married?
No. I got a job this week tracking someone.
Fantastically fantastic. I knew you could do it. Yeah, keep up the good work.
It's Kurt Duncan.
What?
You didn't know he escaped? I need your cooperation on this one.
Yeah, sure. Anything you want. Anything.
Thank you.
Ah, it's you. What do you want?
I came to apologize.
Listen, I'm the one who should be sorry. I didn't mean for that to happen.
I'm new in town. I don't know anybody.
Where are you from? Excuse me. I just got in.
Well,
I don't know if I can. Listen, I can't talk right now. Can I call you back? All right. Bye.
I'm from New York, actually.
Look, you can't come in here.
Oh. Well, I thought perhaps we might get some coffee.
No, I don't think so.
Someone nearby?
Not tonight. You'd better go.
I got no place to go.
Well, you can't stay here.
Just a coffee. Please.
Well, maybe tomorrow.
Okay. Tomorrow. When?
I said maybe. I don't know. Look, I'm sorry about what happened this afternoon. I really am. All right? That was my boyfriend on the phone. He's coming over. So please leave. Now.
I like you.
Look, do you want me to call the cops?
No, it's okay. It's okay. I'll see you sometime. Later. I still want to buy you that drink.
How long will you be here?
Well, it depends on how lucky I get. I want to look through the old files on them and check every recent report of assault, vagrancy, things like that.
Just want to ask you a question, Mr. Trumbull. What was stolen?
Wake up! Hey, God bless you! Get out!
right, all right. Damn it, all right. All right. What's that, partner? Hey, look here. I'm dry as a bone, man. You got any money?
Well, keep the picture. If you think you see him, I'd appreciate a call.
About 4 o'clock.
Oh, yeah? Down by the park, huh? Foreigner has a British accent.
Oh, yeah?
It's about my height, my complexion.
I was just with that guy. Looked bad.
Where?
Oh, hell, partner, I can't remember. Probably see him again, though. I tell you what. You leave that money with me, and I'll see that he gets it as a favor to you.
I gotta talk to him.
What's the matter? Don't you trust me? Hmm? We can work together.
Yeah, sure. Now, you keep the bottle, huh? I'll be back.
Bar downtown?
Yeah, I got the name and the address if you want.
Appreciate it.
John Clifford. I'm a private investigator.
You're a what?
I'm a private detective.
What do you want with me?
I thought maybe we could talk, ask a few questions.
I don't know nothing about anything or anybody.
Listen, lady. I can be back in 30 minutes with a search warrant and a handful of cops. And I could probably have you arrested whether or not the charges would stick. Now, you want to let me in and talk?
Have you got a badge?
I'll show you a badge when you open the goddamn door.
I don't have a badge. I'm issued a license. A piece of paper, and I left it at home. You Tracy Fuller? Will you sit down? You recognize this man?
Why?
He's escaped from the insane asylum. 7 years ago, he murdered 2 children. Broke into the house and found them asleep in bed. There was a little boy, 4 and a half, and his little 3-year-old sister. After the coroner's investigation, the bodies were taken to the mortuary where the undertaker took one look at them and said their bodies couldn't be reconstructed for the burial without 6 days of steady work. Then he asked what had been the murder weapon, because looking at the mess in front of him, he couldn't imagine what had been used. The coroner told him there had been no murder weapon. killer had used only his hands.
He's been here.
You think he'll try to see you again?
I don't know. He said he had no place to go.
Well, let's play it safe. Let's assume he will. Will you work with me?
I think so.
Where?
From here on, I go it alone.
Why take a chance on it, Cliff? We'll let you have the credit.
No. I'm gonna kill him, Charlie. The closer I get to this guy, the more it gets to me. I don't know.
Look, you better go on home, Cliff. You're falling in.
No. Not this time. This is the case that makes up for a whole career. If you don't understand that now, you will in a few years.
Who hired you to do this? So, now you're a hitman.
Jesus Christ, he killed two kids in cold blood. You were there too.
What are you going to use?
Lock needles.
You are straining our friendship, Cliff. If you blow this thing at all,
you'll never hear from me again.
All right. Take your time and do it good.
Okay. All right.
Keep it, honey. My treat.
You see him? He still could be out there, though.
Oh, God.
Are you okay?
Okay.
I'm gonna hang around outside for a while. I'll be back on and off again all night. Sure you're all right?
I'm fine.
Okay. Bolt your door. Don't let anybody in, no matter what.
Okay.
I'll be seeing you. Listen. Thanks.
Sure.
I must talk to you. I want you to be my friend. Please.
Lucky day. Friend of yours has got some money for you. We got to get on back down to the park and meet him. Hey, come on now. Wait, listen, he's gonna be coming for you, Crazy Cut. He's got some M.O. anyway. We can get us a little joy juice, partner. Come on now. Come on. Hey. Come on, man. What's the matter with you? You really are crazy.
Thank you.
Duncan? Duncan? It's over now. Come on out. My name's John Clifford. I'm a private detective. I was hired by Alexander Mandrakis to take you back. I'm not gonna hurt you. I'm not gonna hurt you. Not gonna hurt you. There'll be no more pain. You're safe now. Just come with me. It's all right, Duncan. Duncan!
I don't exist. I was never born. No one can see me anymore. No one can hear me. No one touches me. I'm not here. I don't exist. I wasn't born.
dinner?
Hamburgers.
Hamburgers? I never knew he liked hamburgers. Did you? You get that?
Okay.
Maybe that's Daddy, huh?
Hello.
Hey, how's my little tiger?
Okay, when you coming home?
Real soon. Why don't you let me talk to Mommy, okay?
Okay, bye, Daddy.
Thank you. Hello.
Hi, babe. How's my girl?
Fine. You wanna go with Steve?
Come on. I'm coming.
Bye. You know that dress I got you for your birthday?
Yeah?
Well, now's your chance to wear it, because I'm taking you out to dinner tonight.
What's going on?
A little surprise. Look, I'm leaving here now. I'll be home in half an hour.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye, babe.
Keep. If I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. God bless Mommy and Daddy
and me.
Grandma, Aunt Lucy, Uncle George.
And me.
And her. Now will you read us a story?
No, I will not read you a story. You try and go to sleep, okay?
Okay. Night, Mommy.
Night. And Sharon will be here while we're gone.
Okay.
Okay. Good night. Mommy, will you come here a minute? I want to tell you something.
What is it?
Come closer.
Hmm? What is it?
I love you.
I love you too, Bebel. Good night.
Good night.
Sleep good.
Hi, Sharon.
Hello, Mrs. Lockhart. I saw your picture in the paper the other day. Congratulations.
Wasn't that a terrible picture?
I thought it was nice. Are the kids asleep?
No, but they will be. I give about 20 minutes and then go up and take a peek. But I warn you, if Steven sees you, you're going to have to read him a story.
Okay, let's go.
Okay. Now, I have the number of the restaurant here, and you know the number for police and emergency is 911. You know that, right?
Honey, in 10 seconds, I'm going to eat this staircase.
Yes, Lord and Master.
I'm not wearing anything.
Have a good time.
Okay, thank you.
Bye, Sharon.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
You got everything, right?
Time they recognize you for what you really are.
You know, I'm going to be the youngest district sales manager in the company's history.
Does this mean a raise?
It sure does.
How much?
A lot.
Well, how much? You are kidding. And a car.
Did and a car.
Yes. I'm so proud of you.
What's the matter? Don't you want your food?
Excuse me. Mr. and Mrs. Lockhart?
Yes?
There's a phone call for you.
No, I'll get it. It's just Sharon, I'm sure. Eat your dinner.
What's wrong?
The man! He's at the phone!
Wait a minute!
He's got my baby!
What?
Kurt Duncan!
He's on the phone?
It's my baby! Please! No!
It's okay, honey. Hello, Sharon. This is Mr. Lockhart. What's going on over there?
Nothing's going on.
Is everything all right?
Yes, there's nothing going on. Everything's fine. Why? What's the matter?
Sharon, listen to me very carefully. Look, if there's a man in the house, if there's any reason why you can't talk to me right now, just answer yes over the phone. If there's any danger of any kind, just say yes.
I don't understand. What man in the house?
Sharon, please do me a favor. Just tell me truthfully. When was the last time you checked my children?
About 45 minutes ago. Everything's fine. They were fast asleep.
Oh, Sharon, I'm sorry about the hysterics. We're leaving the restaurant now, and I'll explain everything as soon as we get back. Before we hang up, would you do one more thing for me?
What?
Would you go upstairs and check the children?
No!
Me?
Sure.
Excuse me.
Hold on.
Excuse me. What's the problem, sir?
Officer, I'm in the lock box. Just a second, please. I'll explain everything.
Sharon!
Jill, I'm here. We're both here. We're safe now. Okay. Look, if it'll make you feel any better. I'll keep it right here beside me all night long. You know I'm a light sleeper and a damn good shot. Satisfied?
I'm sorry to be putting you through all this.
Oh, come on.
Hey, Bert. This report just came in on that guy, Kirk Duncan. Seems he broke out of the nut house about 3 weeks ago.
Oh, yeah? You gonna put this in our report?
Diamonds, Charlie. Diamonds was left.
Yeah, I think we should put it in the report. Maybe this gal tonight really did get a call from him. Who knows?
Your lead, Charlie. What the hell are you doing? That's a trump.
A card lead is a card play. Yeah, you're right. We better leave this on Rusnik's desk in the morning. Sorry, fellas. Get them all from me. I got them all.
Jesus Christ.
I can't help that. Say, Omar. Can I see this a minute?
Yeah.
You guys have a stakeout on this house?
Yeah, Bernstein and Waller are checking in every about 20 minutes or so.
Thank you.
Cliff. I think I got something for you.
Oh, yes. Honey, where'd you get this? The candy. Where'd you get the candy?
Operator, what does that mean?
I'm sorry, sir. That line seems to be disconnected.
And why don't I get a recording?
I don't know, sir. Maybe the number was just recently disconnected. Or maybe there's a temporary malfunction in the wiring. Could you try it again in the morning?
Yeah, okay. Thanks.
Thank you.
you know why.
Thank you.